Hello everyone and welcome to the workshop. Today we're going to be taking a look at one of the first PCIe adapters in the market for the Raspberry Pi 5. These are the Pineberry Pi HatDrives. There are two different versions, one that attaches on the top of the Pi and one that attaches at the bottom of the Pi. We're going to be taking a look at both. We're going to see the pros and cons of using these PCIe adapters. So first, let's take a close look at the adapters themselves. You can see this one is the top version, so it goes on the top of the Raspberry Pi 5. It's connected to the Pi 5 through this FPC cable, and it fits 2230 and 2242 SSD drives. Right now I have the 2230 because those are the drives that I use on my CM4. I have a few of these around. So there are a few things that I like about this head drive and a few things that I don't like about this head drive. One thing that I like is that you can see there, I can fit the active cooler and the hat drive on top, and it fits just fine. And I have ran some tests and it keeps it pretty cool. The hat on top does not cause any issues with the active cooler inside. So I like that. One thing that I don't like is that you can see here, I can't really run camera cables. The drive is blocking the path of the cables. I can't route them this way, and this post is blocking routing this way. Even if the post wasn't there, I can't really get it through this gap between the Ethernet and the hat drive. So that's one thing that I don't like. So Pineberry Pi sent me this hat drive to test it out. They didn't include an accessory that's supposed to come with the head drive, which is an extended header that I would be able to plug in the hat to the Pi 5 through the GPIO pins. It's not really needed. I've been using it without the extender header, and it works fine. It does add some capabilities, like it can pull power from the 5-volt GPIO, but I find that just using the FPC cable, it works just fine. FPC is also able to provide 5 volts, and it has some power controls here on the board that provides the 3 volts that the SSD needs. So Pineberry Pi has this model, which is the top hat, but they also have this bottom hat here. The main difference between the bottom, it's not really a hat since it doesn't attach on top, or the bottom adapter, let's call it that way, is that it allows for the full-size 2280 drives. Those drives can be a little bit faster than the smaller drives because they have caching on them. For my use, I don't really see the need to have a full-size SSD plugged into my Pi, so the 2230 has been working just fine. So the setup that you just looked at was the setup that I used to have on my workbench with the Pineberry Pi hat drive on top of my Pi 5 without a case. But I have recently moved to using this passive cold case that I have a video on up here somewhere. So let's take a look at this setup now. I got the passive cooling case that I've been using on my workbench. It's a really nice case. I have a video on it. I'll put the link in one of the cards or in the description below. And I decided to test the Pineberry Pi hat with this case. I had to put a little dot of blue tack over there so it's supported on that side of the case. And I also had to get extended headers for my Pi 5, but it's working really well. I can just plug it in. Let's line it up. Push it down and stays really well. And you can also see that I switched from the 2230 to the 2242. I got this 512 gigabyte SSD on Amazon for about $60. I noticed that the 1 terabyte version is double that, it's 120. I'll put some links in the description below also. I haven't tried the camera cables or the display cables coming out of the slots and routing through, you know, the gap between the hat and the Ethernet connector. I might try that. I also don't have anything supporting the board besides the extended header. It's okay. Like I said, I had to put that little dot of blue tack. Seems to be working pretty fine. I think the case is still doing its job, still keeping the Pi 5 cool. So it looks like a really nice, compact setup. Pretty excited to use this. There's a little bit of setup that you have to do on the Pi 5 to make sure that you're booting from the NVMe drive attached to the hard drive. But it's super simple though, you just have to edit one line on the EEPROM configuration for the boot order. So 6 means PCIe, it's read from right to left, so you have to have 6 as one of the first items, so the rightmost in the configuration line. And you have to use PCIe probe to make sure that the Pi 5 is enumerating through the PCIe connector and finding that boot drive during boot. Make sure to boot your Raspberry Pi 5 before attaching the head drive so the EEPROM can be updated before you attach it. After you reboot the system, the Pi should be looking for the NVMe drive on the head drive, and you should be able to see it mounted to the Pi 5. Burning the OS image to the NVMe drive is super simple. You can either use Raspberry Pi Imager and just burn the image directly to the NVMe drive, or you can do like I did, which is use the SD card copier to copy the setup they already have to the NVMe drive. I used the SD card copier. It's not just for SD drive, it's for anything that you want to copy that has the OS image for the Raspberry Pi 5, because I already had a desktop setup and I wanted to reuse that. It's the desktop setup that I like using, something that I'm comfortable with. I didn't want to start from scratch with a brand new OS. I always check the unique identifier checkbox on SD card copier to make sure that assigns a unique identifier to your boot drive. This way you can plug in the old boot media and the new boot media at the same time on the Pi 5. If you don't have a new identifier, it doesn't work. I really like the top hat just because it's so much more compact and allows me to use NVMe drive on Pi 5, which is a fast and reliable media. One thing that I don't like is that I can't run the camera cables through the hat drive, so in that regard, the bottom version might be better. The problem that I see with the bottom version is that it's not really easy to fit inside a case. Pineberry Pi is going to be coming out with their own case in the future, but for right now, you just mount it and your Pi just sits there. Another thing that I do like about this setup, like I said, it's so compact, but it doesn't have all the cables attached to it like an external SSD drive. Before, you know, I always had the external SSD drive, even on my Pi 4, just sitting there. I didn't know what to do with it. This setup is so much better. You can see here my desktop has just so much more streamlined with all the cables plugged in, and it's just one unit. So what do you think? Are you looking for other PCIe adapters for the Raspberry Pi? Are you planning on buying the hat drive, or are you just planning on using a good old SD card? Let me know in the comments below. I'd love to know your setup. And this is it for today, so I'll see you guys in the next video.